And for number three, we have Middle-earth, Shadow of Mordor. I don't know whose cat this is.
Middle-earth, Shadow of Mordor is going to change everything. Iteration can be a slow process in video games, but every year or two we get a jumpstart with an idea so revolutionary and perfectly executed that it creates a roadmap for others to follow. Shadow of Mordor's nemesis system is the heart and soul of this latest journey to Middle-earth, creating a constantly shifting hierarchy of foes to battle. Navigating the messy world of Uruk politics allow you to create your own player stories in a way that is more engaging and personal than your usual scripted events. The eventual ability to assert your own influence casts a further wrinkle into the already groundbreaking idea. Still, Mordor may not have made the cut in our year's favorites if it weren't so refined from top to bottom. It borrows parts from both the Batman Arkham and Assassin's Creed series, and matches or exceeds them in both. Every mechanic, from rhythmic combat to the stealth, simply sings. It also strikingly sets itself in the familiar tropes of the Lord of the Rings series, but finds a way to tell an original story that feels like it has some weight and impact to the events from which we are already familiar. Middle-earth, Shadow of Mordor began its life chastised as an imitator. Its combat and stealth influences made it appear to be a competent license game, but a little more. Much to our surprise, it turned out to be more original than met the eye, and no one can fairly call it an imitator anymore. If anything, other games will be looking to imitate it.